ahead and split the committee into two distinct scrutiny committees. One to deal with adult social care and health, and the other to look at all children's services in the round. To go along with that, we made some recommendations, and I'm going to ask Serge in a minute. We made four recommendations. The first one is that we divide the committee into two in the way that I've described. The second, that we allocate the number of places on political proportionality. Now, we came up with a figure, but to be honest, it wasn't based on anything except sort of random preference, yes, a random preference. And since that time, I've had some advice from Sergeant that we would be it would be more sensible to refer the actual number of members of the committee to a working, a future working party. Do you want to explain the reasons for that?
Yes, yes, Chair. At the working group, I think we speculated on the numbers being reduced to 11. What wasn't fully appreciated at the time was the potential implications to other committees and the overall numbers in terms of seat allocation and the proportionality that would be required. In order to allow for 11, it will be for open scrutiny committees, assuming council agrees. There would be other implications to other committee numbers in order to ensure the overall political proportionality is correct, which clearly wasn't discussed at the working group. I think it's important that members are fully aware of the implications before we change the numbers. So the suggestion is retain the 15 membership number for the additional committee, with a view to this issue being looked at as part of the working group's work programme in the next municipal year, so that members can at least consider fully the implications of reducing the open scrutiny membership numbers and what the impact could be on other committees.
We're all comfortable with that. I think it is a more thorough piece of work than we did at the working body, where it was a fairly random suggestion about numbers. As well as that, I've taken some soundings of our group, and our group's view on this is that as many members of the council as possible should be involved in scrutiny, since it's such an important part of the council's work. And so for that reason, I think if the committee is agreeable, we will include in this that at the moment we maintain the number of committee places of 15, and they'll be subject to a further piece of work by the working party.
Sorry, yes, sorry, 15 for each of the junior committees?
Each of the all four committees, because we couldn't change the makeup of two scrutiny committees without being impacted on the other two scrutiny committees. And as Serge is saying, that then would have implications for all the other council committees if we did that. And so rather than make a decision that would be perhaps challengeable or cause difficulty, I think we'd best stick with the same number for now and then review it across the
whole. Just to be clear, what you're saying, these two new committees that we're about to create
would both have 15 members.
Total of 15 or each?
Each have 15 members.
So it's like four committees with 15
four committees, yeah, each with 15 members.
Just trying to sort of recap on what we agreed last week.
What we agreed.
We said 11,
but the understanding would be 11 for all four committees. Yes. And since then, Sergeant has said that would have an